now approaching our destination and will be docking momentarily. For your safety, please stay where you are until we are safely docked and the captain has given the all clear. Because this is a... We ask that you please clear the stairway. Everyone else, please remain where you are until we've completed our docking.
Watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town, gather round.
Oh, I like these of the dog. 'Tis the season to be jolly.
Oh, the sparkliness.
Too much. Too much. Cheers.
Get the monkey mask?
That side is
the zebra. Okay. Ooh, the dolphin.
I like the parrot. Show him from the side.
And they're designed to be worn or just displayed?
He's got those qualities.
Oh, yeah. So does the gator, though. So it is Thursday, and for me, that's fishing day.
I ain't rich, but sure wanna be. Working like a dog all day ain't working for me. I wish I had a bitch uncle that kicked the bucket, and I was sitting on a pile like Warren Buffett. I know everybody says money can't buy happiness, but it can buy me a boat. It can buy me a truck to fill it. It can buy me Yeti 110 eyes down with some silver bullets. Yeah, and I know what they say, money can't buy everything. Maybe so, but it can buy me a boat. They call me a redneck, white trash, and blue collar. But I could change all that if I had a couple $1 million. I keep hearing that money is the root of all evil, and you can't feed a camel through the eye of a needle. I'm sure that's probably true, but it still sounds pretty cool. Cause it could buy me a boat, it could buy me a truck to pull it. It could buy me Yeti 110 eyes down with some silver bullets. Yeah, and I know what they say, money can't buy. But it could buy me a boat to float down on the water with a beer. I hear the Powerball on a whistle sitting on a 100 mil. Well, that would buy me a brand new riding reel. It can buy me a boat. It could buy me a truck to pull it. It could buy me a Yeti 110 eyes down with some silver bullets. Yeah, and I know what they say, money can't buy everything. Maybe so.
Loaded up and we're headed back home. All this traffic was small. Small groupers, really weird in that area. All right, we're home, everybody. Say hi.
Hi.
All right, so I've got her washed down, ran the motor with the fresh water, and so it's about ready to put away. She's still wet, so I'm not gonna put the cover on her tonight. Probably wait and do that tomorrow. Here's what I wanted to show you guys. I'm trying to get organized down to like 3 or 4 boxes, so when I go, I'm ready to run. Here's a, this is an O-ring, not watertight, but it's got an O-ring closure, but it's got watertight things in there for my worms, my lures, and jigs and stuff. So that keeps a lot of my basic tackle safe. And then on the top, you know, it's got room for like tape measure, multi-tool, stuff like that. See, it's not waterproof. It still has like a little gap in the O-ring there, so I wouldn't trust that. But then in this box below it, I mean, suntan lotion, you know, bobbers, just stuff that I wouldn't normally use, but just in case I have it in there. And here's another piece to the action. This is waterproof, and that's got like rechargeable batteries in it. It's got wallet, you know, it's where I keep everything, that cell phone, everything that has to stay dry. This is everything I'm going to take inside the house with me. I was telling emergency radio, my nice spotlight, you know, all the electronics, my fish finder. This has got like all the important stuff that I don't want to leave on the boat. I do have a lid for it. I don't know, tell me what you think of this organization system. Then when I get ready to go on the boat, I just grab these things and go. It's about 8 o'clock at night, so I'm gonna take it over and park it back in storage. Jethro, you wanna go? Yeah, he wants to go. He always wants to go. Come on, in the lower step. Come on, up. So. He's doing pretty good with his. Come on, get it. Hup, 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 hup. There he goes.
good. There's Chris. Say hi. So got the boat put away, and now it's time to relax in the pool. Nice 95 degree heated pool. It's like a hot tub in here. It's like a sauna.
Alright everybody, real quick before we cut you loose for the end of season two, I hope you're excited about what's coming up for the next season. I really want to say thank you to all of our subscribers. Those of you that have clicked that subscribe button down below, you don't know how much it means to us to see that number go up one by one. So if you're not a subscriber, please click the subscribe button, click the like button. We got a lot more stuff in store for you coming up. Season three. Starting with this, so we got a drone action coming up that's going to come in handy with a lot of our fishing stuff we got planned. I'm going to be hitting up a lot of the lakes over here in Polk County. We got a lot of lakes, got the chain of lakes around Winter Haven. We're going to start with Lake Cartridge, and I've heard tales of 7 and 8 pound bass in that lake, so stay tuned for that. That's coming up in season three. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed season two. It was it was a good learning experience. Got me a little bit more functional in the editing. I've got some new video editing software. I'm tossing all this old stuff out, and we're starting with the new Resolve, is what it's called, is the software that I'm gonna be using to edit our new shows coming up. So I hope you guys enjoy that. Otherwise, thank you again for watching. Thank you for being subscribers. If you're not a subscriber, please click subscribe, like below, and I will see you for the season premiere of season three coming up shortly. But as for now, season two, done.